This is also a different study of isatuximab, which is, as you know, a second generation, or the second, it's not second generation, but the second anti-CD38 monoclonal antibody, in which it has been combined with two different regimes, VCD and VRD, for transplant-ineligible multiple myeloma patients. We already reported this trial, and that this is an update of the data we have got with it. So in the ISA VCD with bortezomib cyclodex, 17 patients were included, with almost all of them, but one achieved a partial response or better, and many of them VGPR, CR, CNCR, also the majority, 10 out of the 15 achieved the VGPR or better. So I think it's a good, well-tolerated and good combination. With regard to the VRD, we have more patients here. We have 26 evaluable patients for efficacy, and the response rate is 100%, and the majority of them achieve VGPR or better. I have to say that these patients were quite old. In fact, I have today, I see, so one patient in the open clinic with 87 years old, which is still on this arm with ISA-VRD and followed by ISA-RD, lenalidomide dex, as maintenance. The median PFS is not reached, because but only three events have been reported in this ISA-VRD cohort. It's interesting. We have a problem here. We don't have an interference assay. But regarding the MRD, so many patients that are IgG kappa, we cannot exclude the possibility, we cannot define as CR because of this absence of interference with this isatuximab. But we know that if around 40 to 50% of the patients achieve MRD negativity, depending on the cohort, by NGF or NGS methodology at 10 to the minus 5, which is important for this elderly population. And also another message important for this trial is that we have the opportunity to evaluate the M component by mass spectrometry. And in this case, we saw that all MRD positive patients, like NGF or NGS, were also mass spectrometry positive, so there was a concordance. But what was important is in the MRD negative patients, because out of 10 patients, only two of them were MRD negative and mass spectrometry negative. Eight of these 10 were MRD negative, but still with some protein detectable by mass spectrometry. So suggesting that this technique appears to be more sensitive than MRD to detect the residual disease. I think we need more data, but this is also interesting. Regarding safety, both combinations were well tolerated. There was some hematological toxicity, not many, and infections. Infections could be the main concern, but with 40% of patients had a grade 3 or more infections. I think they are well managed in this elderly population with those reductions and antibiotics.